inventory systems, probably something every gamer is familiar with. They come in so many shapes, from simple lists you can scroll through, raster-based layouts, or these tasty pie menus. Sometimes you've got weight limits, sometimes you're forced to play Tetris, and sometimes you have no idea how to manage your quick slots. And sometimes a developer thinks this inventory system will do the trick. Yep, that's right. This is what I thought was the best inventory system for my game 4 years ago. A few pictures, some multiplier text, and no way to select an item. The game handled everything on its own. If an item was required, the system checked if the player had it and just used it automatically. Sounds a bit boring, right? And the best part, you couldn't even hide it. It was always on screen. Definitely something I'm not proud of. So after staring at the system for years, I finally decided it had to go. So the first question was how my new inventory system should look like. Let's take a short dive into game design theory. There are four ways a user interface can be implemented: non-diegetic, meta, spatial, and diegetic. They differ depending on whether they are included in the game's fiction and whether they exist in the game's spatial environment. Let's put them into this neat diagram. A non-diegetic UI is neither part of the game's story nor the game's world space. It's just an overlay for the player, invisible to the characters. For example, in Hogwarts Legacy, the UI shows life bars, player stats, and a minimap. The meta UI is placed in the game's story, while still not being in the game's world space. Think of the phone in GTA 4. While it's still just an overlay in the heads-up display, the game characters are interacting with the phone like it was real, answering calls and sending messages. Spatial UI is part of the game's world space, but not included in the game's story. For example, in Left 4 Dead, items or allies are highlighted with a glowing outline. The player sees it, but the characters don't. And then there's diegetic UI. This one is integrated into both the story and the game's spatial world. This way, the player and the game character interact with the same elements. A great example is Firewatch, where the character holds a map and a compass in their hands. This not only feels immersive, it also blocks your view and interaction with other objects. Alright, enough theory, let's get back to my inventory system. Since immersion is such a big part of horror games, I decided to create a diegetic UI. Especially in scenes with enemies, this can really raise tension. Imagine being chased by a monster and there's a chain door in front of you. You have to look down into a bag to pull out a bolt cutter, all while not being able to see where the monster is. So a backpack it is, placed right in front of the player. What should it be capable of? First, inventory management. I considered a physically based system where you just throw your items inside a bag. I actually built one like this for my bachelor's thesis in VR. But with mouse and keyboard, that would be frustrating. Instead, I went for a kind of grid-based inventory. Players can see all collected items, inspect and combine them. Next, I wanted to have a keyring on its side to keep things a bit organized. And finally, a folder to store all collected letters so they can be read a second time. Additionally, the backpack should be able to make noises when there's lots of items in it. For the design, I needed a backpack that could fully open when it's laid down. As a first step, I modeled a placeholder backpack so I could start coding the mechanics before settling on its final design. But before I dive into the code, let's break down the functions. First is the grid-based inventory system, where items can be placed in valid spots. Backpack extensions can add more space as the game progresses. The second function is about the item management. Players should be able to move items, use them, swap and combine them with other items, inspect them, and delete them. The third function is the keyring. Players should be able to select a specific key and use it on doors. Point 4 is the letter folder, where letters are displayed and can be read out loud. The fifth point is the saving system. And finally, as a last point, I wanted to add a weight mechanic. The more items a player has in the inventory, the louder it gets, which can attract nearby enemies. Step 1 was to create the grid system. I placed empty objects at each valid spot named after coordinates. If the left or right extension pockets are collected, they automatically add new slots for the player to use. For the item management, I created every item as a prefab and put them in the resources folder to load them. These prefabs include the 3D model of the item and their stacked version, and a selection outline. Then I did some coding magic and ta-da! The items were interactable. For the keyring, I put the key model into an empty parent object with an offset on the y-axis. This made it easier to move the keys along the keyring. For the ladder folder, I tested different designs in Blender, a book, and several different sliding animations for the ladders. In the end, I settled on an empty folder with letters that flip like book pages. I first tried bending them with an armature, but after I couldn't manage to wrap the text mesh around the bent pages, I stuck with rigid letters. For the saving system, I went through the dictionary containing all stored items, keys, and letters in the backpack. These were all written in a save file, containing the item name, its coordinates in the backpack, and quantity. The last point was the weight system. The more items in the backpack, the more noise it makes. This can attract nearby enemies, as it increases their hearing radius, displayed with a green sphere in the video. Once the basics were done, I polished the details. Laying the backpack on the ground, switching between categories, adding some non-diegetic UI elements where necessary, and audio feedback. Oof, that was a lot. Thanks for sticking with me. The rest is easier, I promise. Next came 3D modeling, and this took forever. Whenever I wasn't in the mood for coding, I looked at old backpacks and modeled a lot of different meshes. I even 3D scanned my own backpack. Didn't help much, unfortunately. But after weeks, I finally found a design I was happy with. The lid of the backpack is split in two to keep the model as compact as possible. For the grid system, I imagined a checkered leather pattern. So let's get right into texturing. I went with matte fiber optics combined with leather parts and added some small details for realism. Since players would have a really close look, I decided to go with high resolution textures. Back in Blender, I added an armature and created some small animations for opening and closing the backpack. And then finally, I could swap this dirty placeholder model with the final design. Let's see it in action. What a journey, from a simple static UI bar to a fully diegetic backpack with 3 compartments. I actually created this backpack 1 year ago, and as you may have noticed, the game is already pretty big. I would really love to show you the whole journey of how the game got here. So if there's any topic you want to see, let me know in the comments and leave a like and subscribe so you don't miss the next video. Thanks so much for watching and see you next time.